Do you believe you live on a globe?
On a globe as in the world?
Yes. Could I ask you, what's your number one proof that you believe that?
Ingrained in you, hasn't it?
Yep.
So, yeah.
If I asked you if you could give me the number one proof that you live on a globe.
A picture from space.
Picture from space.
Picture from space.
Do you think that those are real?
Yeah.
You do? Do you believe you live on a globe?
Yes.
You do?
Uh-huh.
Can I ask you why?
Science kind of proves that.
Well, this is the thing, but I should have said this before I started. I love science.
Right.
And I'm a natural science guy. Do you know what natural science is?
Not exactly.
Natural science is basically observing the world, you know. And you know, science like that should be based on empirical proof, which is testing, observing, repeating,
mm-hmm.
so that we come to understandings about reality and stuff like that. So you were saying you believed you lived on a globe.
Yes,
but
aye.
Do you know why?
Well, there's scientific measurement. We've been in space, we can actually observe that.
You've been to space?
I've not been to space, no.
Do you think those images that you see are actual photographs?
Yes.
You do?
Aye.
Although they tell you on the NASA site they're not.
Do they?
Yes.
Right, okay.
If we were living in a sphere, we would have real 24-hour video, real images from space, but we don't.
And we'd have to, how can you provide evidence that the pictures aren't real?
Just they tell me. NASA.
They haven't told me that they... That
go to their website and they'll tell you that all their images are composite images. They're composite images, they're not photographs. And the reality is that none of those photographs or videos are actually real. Yeah, they tell you on their website. Honestly, they're composite images. How would you feel if I says this to you? There is absolutely zero, none, real pictures from space. No video, no pictures, none of them are real.
And the point of the fact I've never been there to witness it myself, you could be talked into that. A different person could be talked into that.
Exactly.
I believe.
So, but you understand that you believe it because of the images that they show you. So does it not shock you that none of the images are real?
I think these images are real.
Well, why do you think that?
It's just because... Why do you think that?
Why do you think
this? I think I just accept them. I mean, I think I'm halfway. I trust.
You trust them? Well, that's all. That's what we're looking for. We're looking for an honest answer. The fact is that NASA tell you on their website that the images they're showing you are computer generated. None of them are real. They tell you they're images, they don't tell you they're photographs. They've done that deliberately because then they could be held accountable for misinforming people. Do you believe you live on a globe?
Yes, I do.
You do? Can I ask you why?
Just because there's images from space that well, there's enough scientific proof to prove that we do.
The same as these two guys.
Scientific proof.
Could you give me your best proof that you're on a globe?
I'd have to Google some sort of image of the world, but that's as good as it comes.
So would it be true to say that you believe it's a globe because you were taught that?
Yeah, that's
accurate. What about yourself?
Tim Peake's Twitter account.
So you believe Tim Peake?
But I believe in all the science, but also all of the images that we've seen of the Earth in space.
Do you both believe that you live on a globe?
Yeah.
You believe you live on a globe?
Yeah.
Can I ask you one at a time? Why? What would be your number one proof that you lived on a globe?
I don't know. I think just because from a young age we've all been kind of taught that.
Yep. Great response. So that's for you, that's your reason?
I think Evdale speaks about it like that as well though, there's not really much else that speaks about it differently.
So you were taught it from nursery school
and
you carried on through life and they showed you plastic globes and everybody just believed it.
If I asked you, do you believe that you live on a ball?
Do you believe that you live on a ball?
Yeah.
Do you believe? I take it you believe you live on a sphere, a globe?
Mm-hmm.
Could you tell me your number one proof for why you believe that?
Gravity.
Gravity?
Mm-hmm.
What is gravity?
Well, I suppose everything goes to the centre of the Earth.
Yeah. Could you give us a practical example of that? Yep. So I can explain that as the keys and the materials that that's made of is more dense than the medium that it's in the air right now.
Yeah.
Therefore it falls. but they have to invent these incredible magic forces. So you've got a magic force that they call gravity that can hold trillions upon trillions of tons of water stuck to a globe.
Yeah.
But a tiny midgie or a tiny fly can float, no problem. Without the sphere, all you need is density and buoyancy.
So what's the force pulling my keys to the floor?
Density, because the keys are so dense. Here's the thing, you get a helium balloon, the helium balloon rises. Why? Yeah. Where's gravity?
Well, the helium is lighter than oxygen.
Exactly. So why do we need gravity? Because you understand that it's more less dense than the oxygen, so it rises. It's not because of any forces, other than it being lighter than the environment that it's in.
Yeah.
So you have natural science, you have formal science and social science. Things like mathematics are a formal science because they don't depend on empirical observations. You can start from an axiom or a presumption, you can create a mathematical model. You understand these types of things.
Yeah.
So natural science for me is observable, testable, repeatable. Would you agree that that's the core of science?
Yeah.
So if I make a claim to you about reality, I should be able to scale it, produce it, repeat it, and everybody can then do that. Would you agree?
Yeah.
Would you agree? Yeah. So, could you give me one practical example of a body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape?
Off the top of my head, no. I don't know.
No. You couldn't. Can I ask you why you think that's not possible?
Not sure. I failed science, so I've got no idea.
I'm struggling as well, I'm afraid.
Could you give me one practical example of a body of water conforming to the exterior of any shape?
Body of water conforming to a shape.
Yeah. It's not reality, is it? You know, if I was to show you a test tube of water, you know that it's contained and it's flat at the top. A bathtub of water, a swimming pool, a dam, a lake, an ocean. This physics don't change. So if we were standing here and the ground was starting to curve away from us with water on it, the water would flow.
Yeah.
So does it make you question then the validity of people telling you that you live on a sphere?
A body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape. Well, sure, if it was in a tank.
Yeah, but it's taking the form of the tank.
Ah, that's what
I mean. So if I say this to you, bodies of water must be contained, they will take the shape of their container.
Right, yeah.
You understand, right?
Yeah,
a body of water, the pond over there, the surface is always flat.
Aye, and whatever's underneath is whatever's underneath.
Yep, but from one end of the pond to the other, or any body of water will be at the same level. If there's no, the water will start to flow.
Flow, that's right.
Right, so you understand that, right? Uh-huh. So they say that the Earth's 80% covered in water.
Right.
We know how water behaves.
Yep.
So how can we be living on a globe?
Atmospheric pressure, I'm guessing here. I don't know.
But natural science again, can you give me a practical example?
Well, water is, the seas are fairly stable and level apart from the tides,
yep.
Which the moon controls, so that's where the tides go up and down.
I'm going to have to push you for proof if you say stuff like that to me.
Well, I've seen the tide go up and down.
You've seen the tide go up and
down?
But the only reason you think that it's the moon that's dead is because that's what they told you.
Yes, aye.
Right, so, but there's absolutely zero proof for that. There's so many contradictions against it.
Well, there's a large body of water. You know that that's absolutely flat and parallel. Because that's how water behaves. If I was to bend the sides of that down, what would happen to the water?
I don't know where the heck it would go to.
All water finds and seeks its own level. As soon as it finds that, the surface here will be perfectly level and flat. That's how we used it in construction years and years ago. If I wanted to find if something was level, I would use water. They use spirit levels and stuff. You know, we know all these things. See, if I had a big hole somewhere, and I wanted to find out if it was level, I'd fill it with water. It's the most accurate measuring tool we have. If you used a laser's fine in smoke and, you know, in a house and stuff. As soon as you go to a big environment, if I was to measure across there, the laser would start getting sprayed everywhere because it's affected by the moisture in the air. You know, refraction, reflection, and stuff. So water's more accurate.
So that's the thing, you know, the place is 80% covered in water. That tells me beyond any shadow of a doubt that ain't no fucking globe.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm going to look into this and I'm cool. Really interested. I just want to know, what do you think it is?
Well, right now, you know, on my channel, we don't claim any map or model through. As I say, you get the agencies who try and, you know, because there's a lot of attention on this, because obviously it's a huge secret. So they try and, push these maps and models and then try and get you to adopt them so they can attack it, because there's flaws in it. So what I would suggest to you is, if you get into this, don't listen to the end of it telling you this is what the flat earth is, this is what it looks like, because it's all bollocks. Right? We don't know what it is. Our stance is, we know beyond a shadow of a doubt that it's not a globe, but what we need now is full exploration. We need the world awake to it, and we need all the militaries in the world exploring in order to find exactly what the full dimensions are, because it's being hidden for us right now. You know how water behaves, liquid. You could never, if I was to get a huge swimming pool and submerge a shape under the water, would you expect to see the shape in the top of the water? Of course you wouldn't. Of course you would. You know, we build, construct based on these principles. Water is a natural element. You know, it has a natural law and behaviour to it. And we use it in construction, we have done for thousands of years, you know, by using it as a level. Because we understand that it's a part of reality and it's a definite reality, that's how it behaves. So we can depend on it. So what I would say to people then is, how can we deliver on a sphere? Well, if you were making a cup of tea or running a bath or a swimming pool, you understand that water has to be contained.
Right.
If I was to say to you, you know, let's build a huge swimming pool here, and then I was to say to you, well, look at the middle of the water, there's a hump in the middle of the water, you would know that that was ridiculous, wouldn't you?
Right.
So how can you live on a globe when the place is covered 79% of water? You know, you run a bath, you go to a swimming pool, you go to a lock or a dam, and you know, like the pond there, you know that it's, that to me is just a smaller representation of an ocean.
Yeah.
An ocean's no different. The physical properties don't change on scale. Mm. You know, it's not like the oceans are made of jelly or souffle, yeah, where it can curve round the exterior of a ball.
Okay.
Water doesn't behave like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter who tells you.
Yeah.
And it's no scientific unless you can show me it.
Yeah.
You know? Would you agree with that?
Yeah.
Like, if I say I've got a pint unicorn, and I say, and you say, show me, and
yeah,
I can't show you, are you going to believe that?
No,
I've got a
pink? No.
Of course you're not going to believe
no.
it. So it's about common sense. If I took a shape, a square, a triangle, a pyramid, and I tried to get a body of water to cling to it, run the outside of it, you know that's no reality.
It's not going
to
happen.
Right, so that's what I'm saying to you.
No,
if it's not testable, repeatable, observable, how is it reality?
But surely our atmosphere keeps it in here.
What do you mean?
Well, just that. Like, I mean, I don't know the science yet, I've not started yet.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Well, this is what we're trying to kind of, you know, spark critical thought and common sense in people.
Aye, well, I'll look into this.
There's
no doubt about that.
Aye. So, I've asked you for a practical example of a body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape, and you don't think that's possible?
It's not that I didn't think it was possible, it's just I couldn't think of one off the top of my head.
I'm the same.
Do you think it's possible?
No.
You don't? Well, it's based on what we test and observe 100% of the time. We know for a fact that it will never, if I was to submerge a shape under that water right now, we would never see a silhouette of that shape on top of the water, because that's not how water behaves. So then I'll go back and I'll ask another question. Do you still think you live in a globe?
You'd have to come back to me on that, eh?
Oh, I don't know now. I'm confused.
Still think we live on a globe.
You still think we live on a globe. So I'll go back to the start again. Natural science, real science, practical, testable, observable, repeatable. We know beyond any shadow of a doubt the properties and the behaviours of liquids, and we know that it doesn't conform to the exterior of a shape. So is it science then that vast oceans are claimed to be clinging to the exterior of a sphere?
I'll go for maybe at the moment.
Maybe?
I'd say yes.
You'd say yes, it's possible? But we've established that we don't have any practical example.
Oh, crikey. Oh, I've got no idea.
You've got me there, yeah.
You've got you there. Smart. Honesty is all, that's yeah. what we're not here to convince you and be imposing, we want honesty. So I'll go to my next point. Again, natural science. In natural science, testable, observable, repeatable, 100% of the time, two opposing pressure systems require a solid separation between them, or else we have a thing called equilibrium. Do you understand what that means?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, a vacuum, which is a negative pressure system, and a positive pressure system is what we live in. Do you think that the two of them can exist side by side without a solid barrier?
That's a good question.
Would you have a practical example if you thought it was real?
No.
Right?
I don't have any examples, I don't think so.
So if you had, you took a deodorant can out and removed the metal, you know, and you just had the gas there, would the gas keep its form or would it equilibrate with the rest of the...
It would equilibrate.
Because that's what we know in the test and the reality, 100% thing. So do you still believe that space is a vacuum?
It's a very deep question. again, I'll go for maybe.
This is why I do journalism, this is too complex. Maybe.
Could you give me one practical example of two opposing pressure systems existing side by side without a solid separation between them?
They say that
space is a vacuum,
yeah,
and that we live in a pressurised system, you know. So those are two opposing pressure systems. In reality, when we observe and test opposing pressure systems, you have to have a solid barrier between them or you have equilibrium. So your fridge freezer, a gas canister, you know, if something's a different pressure from the environment, it has to be sealed or it will equilibrate. Do you understand? Well, if you have a vacuum, which is, you know, a negative pressure system, so if you were to go to the back of the fridge freezer that has piping and a condenser and these things, it causes a pressure, same as you're heating in your home, you know, that builds up a pressure. Now, if you were to remove the pipes, what would happen? You wouldn't have pressure, because it would equilibrate with the environment that you're in. So that's what I'm saying. If, you know, natural science requires proof of claims, so like, I can't show you my pink unicorn, you can't show me a body of water conforming to the exterior of a shape, nor can you show me two opposing pressure systems existing side by side without a barrier between them. So why would I accept that as reality? Only because of NASA and these institutions. So you know they tell you that space is a vacuum,
mm-hmm,
and that we live in an atmosphere, a positive pressure system.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So I can say there's a negative pressure system and a positive pressure system. Now, in reality, two opposing pressure systems 100% of the time require a solid separation.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree with that?
Mm-hmm. Go along with that, eh?
Yep, because that's reality and that's what we observe. So why would you then believe it was different on a larger scale?
In what sense?
Well, they're telling you that there's a vacuum up there.
Right.
And that we are in a pressurised system and there's no solid barrier between the two of them.
But is it not the atmosphere?
Well, the atmosphere is what we're living in right now.
Yeah.
So it's a gas, it's air, it's all these things. It's a different pressure from a vacuum.
So what are you suggesting up there then?
All I'm saying is pointing out the contradictions of what we test in reality.
Mm-hmm.
For me, if somebody claims there's another medium up there, there has to be a solid barrier. That's based on natural science. But we want you to trust your common sense. We want you, you know reality. You know, you live in it the same as us. We're all scientists. Natural science is about observing, testing and repeating. Anything that moves beyond that is a religion, as far as I'm concerned. So when people tell you these things, like, we live on a globe. Now, I've got a channel open, and it's been open for 2 years. We've opened it to anybody to come and prove to us that we live on a globe. Do you know how many people we've had doing that?
Not many.
Zero.
Zero.
Why do you think that would be? If we lived in a globe, do you think it would be easy to prove?
If you'd studied it for your full life, probably.
But why your full life?
I don't know, because you've made it sound like it's something that's hard to prove. So,
well, you know, have you ever experienced curvature anywhere?
I don't think so.
Yes, I have.
Where?
I've spent quite a lot of time on ships.
Where have you seen the curvature?
Well, not actually seen it, but trying to remember the best way to describe it.
Yep.
But you can see when you're out at sea, especially with the sun going down, and the higher up you go, you can basically describing this really awfully. Sorry.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
Can I help you, because this is a thing that's it's a perspective issue.
Yeah.
How our eyes work, right?
Yeah.
We have a horizon. You know what a horizon is?
Mm.
You know, the horizon's always flat and parallel, and it will always be at your eye level, no matter how high you go.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we have an issue when we're looking over a long distance because of how our eyes work. Now, if you can agree or disagree, when we look into the distance, the floor rises, the sky comes down, and the sides come in. So if we're looking along a train track, the train track, you can see the width while you're standing. As you look along the train track, it starts to narrow, come in on itself. That's how our eyes work. Now we have a thing called the vanishing point convergence, where things condense so much they become so small that they vanish. Now you'll have heard, I'm sure, in your lifetime that ships disappear over the curvature of the air. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Now you're aware nowadays that we have technology like super zoom cameras. There's one in particular called a P900 Coolpix. We can observe a ship going into the horizon and totally vanishing, totally gone. We can then pull out the camera, zoom back in and bring the full thing into full view again. Okay? Well, we're told that the ships go over the curvature of the earth, but now we've got modern video equipment. We've got things with super zooms on them. So, and there's many, many videos, go and check out yourself.
Do,
so, because this is how our eyes work, there's a convergence point, we've got a perspective. The floor rises, the sky comes down and the sides meet in. Like if you were looking along a rail track, you know, they start to narrow.
Yeah.
Then there's a point where it just converges and it vanishes. Right, that's what happens with ships. Now if you can wait until the ship is totally gone, well out of sight, you can't see it, you can pull one of these cameras up, zoom right in and bring the thing back into full view again. Right.
It's only can I see this somewhere?
YouTube anywhere you like. P900 super zoom. There's loads of guys doing it. They show you the effects, the same effects looking over the salt flats and stuff, where you can create the same, you know, things disappearing that are not disappearing. It's how our eyes work. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just like we've got so much moisture in there. Like right now you look across here, things are coming down to the floor, the sky's coming down, you can see, you know, things get smaller. Right, that's just how I. Every artist paints a flat horizon. Mm-hmm. You understand perspective, but they tell you that it's going over the body of water, right, over the curvature. Now here's the ridiculous thing, right? If you're standing here and the ground starts to slope away from you over there, mm-hmm. right, and I pour water on the ground, what's going to happen to the water?
It's going to run down that way.
Of course it is. Mm-hmm. Right. What I would say to you is this: there's cameras now that Nikon have created called a P900 Coolpix with a super zoom. There's so many people all over Earth now who are videoing the stars and what they call planets, and they're nothing like NASA showed you. Nothing like NASA showed you. They're no solid body things. Most of the stars are like plasmic electrical fields that are just morphing in and out. You know what a logical fallacy is? Right. So if I see circles in the sky, that's no scientific proof that I live on a circle. Right, that's like saying the pool balls are round, therefore the pool table's round. Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand what you mean.
It's a logical fallacy. So I look for real proofs, testable, repeatable, measurable proof of
the
proofs.
But with mathematics.
But mathematics is a form of science. You can start from a false axiom.
But everything is built around mathematics.
No, it's not.
You like the smallest atoms is mathematics.
Yeah.
Like quantum.
Everything
is built around mathematics. Mathematics is the universal language.
Yeah, but this is the thing. Mathematics is reality was here before mathematics. Okay.
Yeah.
So men created a language to describe reality, and they called it mathematics. Mathematics. You can start from a false axiom and build a construct based on your false axiom. Where mathematics is found to be lacking is when you take it and you try and apply it to actual real life observations. Now if you don't have the real life observation, your mathematics is wrong. So they'll tell you in mathematics that water can conform to spheres, you can have negative and positive pressure systems existing side by side in mathematics. So what I'm saying to people is, can you give me a practical example for the mathematics? If you don't have the practical example, there's something wrong with your mathematics. Definitely, and this is the other thing, you know, there is absolutely zero proof for a globe,
right?
There's absolutely...
You can actually see the curvature of the Earth in places.
No, you can't.
No, mate.
It's near. If you go up, doesn't matter how high you go, the horizon will be flat, and parallel with your eyes, it'll be eye level with you, doesn't matter how high you go.
Right, so explain to me then, how would you, right, say you started at point A, anywhere in the globe, and you went all the way around it, and you came back to the same place.
Right.
Right, so how's that work? My dad's done, he's in the medicine area, like he's
told you.
Done that.
Eh? But this is how easy it is, right? And I'm going to show you right
off
now. Right now I'm in the UK, right? And I'm going to go around the world, you watching? It's like there.
Here
I'm back again.
Right.
Is the pavement a round ball?
I can't see for the sun, like,
is the pavement a round ball? No. So do you understand how you could go round the world like that then?
No.
Well, see that big pond over there?
Uh-huh.
See, if I was to go there and I was to put seven continents in it?
Yep.
Right? That would be an accurate representation of the reality we actually live in.
But surely if you went in a straight line from point A and then came back to point A again.
A perfectly straight line?
Yeah, well, as straight as you could do, yeah. Right, you know, being
but,
practical.
But that's hearsay, you know.
How is it hearsay?
Because you've never done it.
Well, I've never done it.
But you know, you say your dad's would win the world. I know people would win the world, but they didn't go in a perfectly straight line.
No, possibly not. Like, I mean, that's it, practically yeah. impossible.
So what we're trying to point out is just how, you know, they say these things to you and they push
as if,
you know, because if I went running a flat plane, mm-hmm. I could still say, oh, I went running the ball, you know, there's nothing any different. What we're looking for is actual proofs that it is a globe.
Right.
So we ask people if they can just give us one, just right. one proof that well, it is a globe.
Off the top of my head, no.
Right.
Just other than what I've been told and what I believe and what I've read
yep.
and people's experiences.
Yeah. So you would you say then it's because of what you were told then?
Yes.
You know, that's perfect. That's exactly what we're looking for.
But
you know, what we're trying to show people is that when you actually look for proof, guys like us, we, you know, we were the same. We believed we lived in a globe through childhood, mm-hmm. all the way up until you actually, you know, applied natural science and you actually looked for real proofs and there's none.
Right.
Everything tells us that it's stationary and flat. Have you ever felt the earth move? Do you think that it does move? Can I ask you why?
I just think it is. I've read about it, so.
Well, how would you feel if I suggested to you that the earth was actually still and it never moved?
I probably believe you, aye.
Well, if I asked you, do you believe it's round? A globe? You don't?
No.
Right, this is good, because this is where we're going.
Quite shocking if I told you that there is absolutely zero pictures and video from space that are real.
There's
none that are
real. None at all?
None.
So they'll all be made in the air, and they've been basically don't like it for that anymore.
Yeah, because you can't get out, it's dead solid up there. It's solid. That's why the stars don't.
There's no wind either.
No.
So why is the flag is flagging if there's no wind?
Well, it never went through.
Of course.
Somewhere. It never went through.
Somewhere in America they made it look like it for the
world. So you know that, so you're aware of that then. Yeah, good, that's good.
I saw probably on television, yeah.
Yeah.
It's being released now that people are lying about these things. But yeah. the thing is that the earth is not a globe. How does that make you feel?
Different than what you thought it was, is it?
Yeah. Well, if I say this to you, it would tell you that the earth is covered 80% water.
Yeah.
Now we know that water seeks its own level,
yes.
and that it will form the shape of its container. Water will never conform to the exterior of a shape.
Something's not quite right.
The ocean. Dude, these guys have been paid to tell these fucking lies, right? It's absolutely ridiculous and total nonsense that people believe that in 1967 they fired a rocket the first time. Never tried it before. Oh, we made it all the way to the moon. Well, they're on the phone to Nixon, 238,000 miles away, on the moon, speaking to Nixon. You know, and the reason people believe it's because they've seen it on the telly. Yeah. So you've never considered that question?
No. I've never been asked either.
And you're thinking about it now?
I'm just thinking about that. Just thinking about the way you have told me this and that, yeah. That's
so true. If I say to you, you know, there's absolutely zero proof that we live on a globe. All the scientific proof tells us that we're stationary and flat.
And that's to say, something never...
No.
I have to be honest, no.
Have you ever felt the earth spin? Have you ever felt any motion?
Apart earthquakes, no.
Earthquakes. Or when you've had a few drinks?
No, I don't drink at all. No.
That's good, that's good.
I know there's all the conspiracy theories, but I did believe men went to the moon until maybe a few seconds ago, and now I'm doubting that fact. Maybe so, there is an alternative fact.
Just like, if I don't have the pink unicorn to show you, is it reality?
Yeah, but you can't prove a pink unicorn in this. You can prove that there is something else in the universe.
So prove to me how a body of water conforms to the exterior of a
sphere. I'm not a scientist. I don't know.
We're all scientists. Natural science is about your common sense and your observations.
Natural science, but like, if you believe that mathematics is the universal language of everything that exists, then I, with my level of mathematics, I can prove anything.
because I haven't read the enough to know this mathematics.
But you still believe what they tell you?
I believe what they tell you because people that are like Isaac Newton, who is maybe probably one of the greatest geniuses ever, that ever lived, tell me that. Like, he and others that have proven his works tell me that. Like, Einstein, I don't say I'm smarter than Einstein.
No, but this is what I'm saying. You're saying that they've proved it. What I'm asking you is, where is the proof?
No, but still, okay, I can't like put my hand on the moon and say this is...
But can you show me how water conforms to a sphere?
No.
Well, why do we believe it?
Because of gravity.
Give me a practical example of gravity.
I just don't understand how you can think... Like, that's like going back to like the 15, 1600s when they thought they were going to fall off the end of the Earth.
But that's what they told you. They told you that there was an edge.
What are you suggesting is there if it isn't?
Nobody knows.
Right.
Because there's a thing called the Antarctic Treaty in Antarctica. Mm-hmm. I think it's 47, don't quote me on that. Yeah. 47 nations, right, uh-huh, work in unison in order to protect Antarctica. Now in the middle, they're all at war with each other. Right, but in Antarctica, many people suggest and many people think, I'm not one of these that's included by the way, that Antarctica is actually all the way round the outside is. What's never been done is north to south circumnavigation. It's probably impossible.
Practically
impossible and physically probably impossible, you know. Because for me,
you can fly though.
It's not a globe.
You can fly.
Well, you could fly, you think you would, and you think with the bodies past, you know, varying pictures and stuff. But I'll go back to it again, you know, you go to NASA's website, mm-hmm, they'll tell you that all the images you're seeing there are composites. Mm-hmm. They're composite images, they're no actual photographs. Because, you know, you kind of get out.
I thought you could see the curvature for there when Concorde was flying. Yeah. Do you know that for a fact?
Well, I know for a fact there's people put balloons up. And there's one I could show you right now at 121,000 feet. Mm-hmm. The horizon's at eye level, as flat as a fucking pancake. Now, if you're on a sphere, right, if you're on the top of a sphere, you start to rise up for the sphere, 360 degrees round you, the horizon would start to drop. So the higher you go, you would start looking down at the horizon, mm-hmm, because you're on a sphere. That's not reality. When you go on a plane and the higher it goes up, the horizon keeps rising to your eye level.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I would suggest that I would stop anybody from adopting any beliefs, because for me, a belief is a substitute for knowing. So right away, I would encourage people not to believe anything, to trust your own senses and to trust real natural science, which is observable, testable, repeatable. That's how we operate, that's how we construct, we have technology. There is an objective reality that's really there that we can measure, test, and depend on. So what I would say is, don't believe in any institution who's telling you that you should believe. For me, there's an issue with that. The fact of the matter is that over 2 years now, myself, we've got a guy, Gavin, who's involved, who has an honours degree from Glasgow University in mathematics and physics. He understands that what he's been told is a lie. I have so many other friends now because they based a lot of this stuff on false axioms. You know, they started from a false premise and then they create a mathematical construct based on a false premise. Now, the false premise in this case is that the Earth is a sphere.
Yeah, but that's what you guys say.
Yeah. Well, again, I went and I searched extensively and I looked for proof and I have found zero proof that the Earth is a globe. There is no measurable curvature. All things in nature, everything in natural science tells me beyond any shadow of a doubt that it cannot be a sphere I'm living on. The mountain of proof that it's flat and stationary is like that. Zero proof for a globe, loads of proof to say that it's flat and stationary. You still believe you live in a globe?
I'm going to have to think about that one. I think so.
You still believe
in
a globe?
You still believe in a globe? What I'll say now is, as I say, my platform's open. If you decide to go away and the seeds have been planted here and you start to go through the process and trying to prove to yourself that it is a globe, would you be willing to come on live? If you think you found proof, would you come on live and share the proof so that you can prove it was all right?
If I find proof, I would certainly come along.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So, measurable curvature, practical examples, you know, these types of things that we've spoken about today. I would really appreciate that, and I can only thank you for your time. All right?
Thank you.
Peter, I mean, how do you feel about that? Is it making you question, or...?
It does make you think about it. Yeah. Like, do we live in a globe?